Hi, in this video we are going to learn more about backtracking. Whenever a regular expression contains a quantifier like a plus or asterisk, or a limiting quantifier without the maximum argument, backtracking might come into play. Whenever there is an opportunity for a regex engine to match a string differently, it will explore as many ways as possible in order to deliver a complete match. Whenever a regex engine finds this opportunity, it saves its state in order to come back to it later when it fails to find a complete match. This process of returning to a previous saved state to find a match is known as backtracking. Let's have a look at the example. Let's match the last occurrence of blah in this string. We will start with a greedy dot pattern and blah word. We can see that we matched all the string up to the last occurrence of blah here. Why? The greedy dot pattern matches all the string to its end first. Then it's going to look for B. As the regex engine doesn't find any B at the end of the string, it backtracks further back into the string and goes up to this location where it finds B, and then it finds LAH letters right after and delivers a complete match. Let's switch off the global modifier. Now let's replace blah with 123. This pattern matches this string as a whole because 123 is at the end of it. What if we make this pattern lazy? We only match up to the first occurrence of 123. This is expected, but what's going on here? The lazy dot pattern is skipped at first, and only 123 is being searched for. So when the regex engine is at the position in front of 7, it tries to find 1, but it can't, there is 7. So this position is failed, and 7 is matched, or consumed, with this lazy dot pattern. It's expanded. Next, there is 8, but 1, 2, 3 cannot match at this position. Again, this 8 is consumed by this lazy dot pattern. It's expanded once again. This sub-pattern expansion goes on until the regex engine comes to this location where it matches 1, 2, 3. You can easily see what the lazy dot matched if you use capture in parentheses. This sub-pattern expansion is also backtracking because the regex engine is actually going back and forth to deliver a complete match. Now let's try and match the last number in the string. We can use backslash d plus to match one or more digits. Let's try the greedy dot pattern and capture the digits. This is a very common mistake. Now you understand why it happens. The greedy dot pattern matched the whole string first. Then it sees that it must match at least one digit. It backtracks, and at this position it can match 3 with backslash d plus pattern, and thus only 3 is captured into the group. In order to capture 1, 2, 3 into the capturing group, you must make sure that the character before this group is not a numeric character. And now you can see that we've got 1, 2, 3 in this group. What if the number is at the beginning of the string? In this case, we should make this pattern optional. Actually, there are other ways to match the first or last occurrence of strings, but we'll cover that in our further videos. If you like my video, please click like and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it yet. Happy regexing!